topics are understanding negotiation in a business environment, understanding how to develop and deliver a presentation, understanding how to create bespoke business documents, and understand information systems in a business environment.
Negotiations in a business environment are vital to sorting out problems and issues, or even getting partnerships within a company. An example would be, for example, like maybe in football, where some of you might know this, where if you negotiate with another company or a sponsorship, such as Nike, you may get benefits such as extra pay, add-ons, or even just getting through in their boots. So that's a way of negotiating with somebody else. The way you can do this is breaking down the negotiation into different parts, such as having a beginning, a middle, and an end. In the beginning, you come with your introduction. In the middle, you come with the main point. And at the end, you have a conclusion, finding out if this is going to work in a negotiation. Taking control in the discussion means that you may come up with a win-win instead of the other person taking control of it, such as you may get offered a deal when you think, well, it's not right. So you're going to have to take control and say, look, I want more benefits. And it may end up in a win-win for yourself. Prioritizing is making sure that your main point in a topic is talked about and is going through to the other person. That person has to take in the topic and say, look, this is actually going to work. So prioritizing that main point and making the other person understand what you're talking about is important. Doing your researching and questioning is really vital. Researching up what you're going to talk about, if you don't do it, then the other person is going to think that you're trying. It's rubbish, basically. So that could be going onto resources such as the internet or reading books, or even talking to somebody within your company. Questioning another person to find out what they want from you, what can happen within the different stages, so that is why we're questioning another person. Dealing with embarrassing arguments, somebody might suggest something that you may not want, and you may have to come up with an answer that says, this is not going to work, so can we do it this way? And if that barrier can't help, then maybe you can go to somebody higher up in the company or somebody you can get help and say, this is happening, so how could we go through this?
When doing a presentation, you could use persuasive language in order to make the person believe you or want to follow you. You could also use inspirational language, such as Martin Luther King and Gandhi, using emotional type language to make them feel that they need to follow you. You could do this face to face using a video and also doing walls and projects. So.
When creating bespoke documents, things such as house style, font, and font size are important. Such as myself working at Lambeth College, we use the font size 11. We have a house style, we have the logo on the right hand side of every document that we read, such as a letter, if we can send it out. I think we use body calibre, is that right? That's how you say it, yeah, that's right. So that's the sort of thing that our house style has, and we have to follow guidelines and procedures. And to make sure, as I was saying before, we have to work within the organisation, legalisations, that's vital. Such as you have to use signatures, data protection, you can't send out people's information to the wrong people. You can't use copyright, you can't go and steal someone's logo from the internet, that's theft. But you can also find out more on the useful link at www.com.uk. And any document that you send, you can immediately get double checked or get the final approval for a manager or a director. Because if you send a wrong document to somebody, you can get yourself in trouble as much as your manager or your supervisor or whoever you're dealing with.
Okay, the different types of information systems are what you're using to pass out the information. So like emails, in my where I work, I use the software called Penis and DocLink, which is an information system. And it's like telling them they are different patients' records and the medical information.
I do that similar at my workplace, which is college. I have to use Columbus, Unity, and a few other things where I've handled a lot of people's learner records. So if I'm to know that they're a wrong subcontractor, which I do at my workplace, that's leaked information. That's not really good. Then I have to go back to explain to my manager what happened. I might get a caution, I might get something. So I have to make sure that data is handed up to the right people and the right information is sent out. As I was saying, that's just handling the data. I've got to make sure that policies are received.